you know, I don't want to talk about everything I've lost in my life and everything I've destroyed. And, you know, I let the devil run my life. I just want to talk about what I've gained, you know, since I've been here. Like most of the men in here, I've experienced bad things and stuff from bad choices and stuff. But bottom line, when I came here from a detox down in Daytona, I'm from Orange Park, and my boss came and got me, and he brought me down here. And I will say, I'll say this much just to, so I can let you know, I've done a lot of time, in prison and all that stuff, and back from years ago, and I hate a bunch of people and all that type of stuff. And they brought me here, and when I got here, they had a prayer circle, and had all these guys with tattoos and scars and everything. And when I saw that, automatically in my mind, I knew I wasn't going to stay here. And so I went and sat back by the shed for 2 days, and I wouldn't say a word. I was kind of like a snake, all pulled up and, thinking something bad was going to happen for the bad things in the past. But guys kept coming up to me and saying, hey, you want to talk about things? And anyway, short story is I felt the Spirit in here. I truly felt the Holy Spirit in here. And all these guys were scarred up and all, inside and out, and it just was unreal. And I try to make a short story of it, but my dad died in an unusual way. I had the house and the kids and all a few years back, and when it happened, he died in my arms, and it was kind of a bad scene. I ran my family off and everything, and I showed the guys this picture, but I went to the woods, and that's where I lived. I stayed in them woods, I lost my house. I voluntarily gave up everything, so I'd go out here and have peace. And that's where I lived. I'd worked enough to drink and all, and I always prayed, but I just gave up on life. Anyway, when I came here, when they took my dad out of my arms, I opened up the Bible and it said, the truth will set you free. And I'm like, for years, I've been wondering, what's the truth setting free? What does this mean? So after 2 days of figuring I'm going to leave here, Brian, our director, had a sermon on the truth will set you free. And it was unreal. And ever since then, I got hooked, to this, what God's doing in here. And I wrote this stuff down, what did I learn since I've been here? Well, one thing I learned is to be humble. I looked in something that really grabs me is Philippians 2:4. It says, look not every man on his own things, but every man on the things of others, as Christ did, and who God highly exalted. And another thing I learned is that I basically had before I got here, but I truly have now, is one thing that's held me back is resentments, anger, and fear, which is a result of anger and stuff like that. And I read the Lord's Prayer, and it says, forgive me as I forgive others. Well, I guess I never was forgiven because I couldn't forgive others for certain things that happened in my life. And once I learned, what God said was truly, I told the guys when I first came here, I was still, alcohol, fog and all. But they were talking about anger and people that, angered them and did them wrong through childhood on up. And I just broke down and started crying. And in front of all the men, I said, one thing I learned, and that is to pray for my enemies. And about a year ago, when I started praying for my enemies, with some was even family that, really did some bad things to, like my dad. And I started praying for them and praying that they would have the same peace and joy and love that I wanted. in my life. And I prayed it every single day. And I learned that from different situations. And I kept praying it till eventually I actually started wanting that for these other people. Then I had that big word called peace. You know, I had actual peace in my heart because I'm not all hemmed up with all this stuff that went all the way back there. I had that peace beyond understanding. And another thing I learned is in Philippians 4:67, it says, 6 and 7, it says, pray to God with thanksgiving in everything, and be thankful. You know, even when we're in bad situations, you know, to be thankful for what you do have and what is going on. And I truly believe that every word in here is true. And if you claim it, if God says he'll do it, he'll do it. He will.
Amen,
do it.
Bro.
And these men will tell you, you know, I came from right here, and I've been claiming something in the Bible for the last 3 months. And I told these men, the night I blessed out, it all came true. Every word that I claimed, it came true because God is not a liar.
That's right.
And anyway, so I just want to read this poem just to tell my story, and I'll leave it at that. I know I said I'm nervous, but because I am.
Come on, win it, Chris.
But this one I revised it over and over, but when I came here, what Brian preached here, you know, first off, I want to say I'm thankful to Mark, I'm thankful to Faith, Brian, all the directors. There's a young man here, Wes, back there. You know, my oldest son is 36, you know, and Wes, he's younger, but I look up to Wes, you know. I look up to all these guys for what they're doing. I look up to God, number one, you know. Mr. Fussell here that comes here every Monday and takes his time for us, for the men here.
Amen.
And, you know, he does well for himself. He's been sober 30 years, but you know what? He's one of us.
Amen. Amen, brother.
That's the kind of men we listen to, is people that's one of us. And when I said it's the truth, sets me free, well, it inspired me, you know, to write this poem, and this is for the men, you know. You know, I put a lot of little Bible verses in the dining room all the time, little poems, and it's all God working through me, you know, because even before I got right with God, I always helped the underdog, the man that was down, and it just continued on with me since I've been here. But, anyway, it says, the truth will set me free. I spent many years running roads with the darkness of my best friend. On empty streets, an empty soul upon a road that has no end. So many years I seek to find through a bottle, girl, or pill. In a search for peace I couldn't find for an empty void to fill. I always laugh or a funny joke as I talk of fun I had. It was all a veil, a lie I spoke. Inside I felt so dark and sad. With a haunted past, and this is for all of us, you know, not even just the men in here, you know, but it's mainly for us, it's set free. With a haunted past, there was no peace, no, my mind was never still. And in a desert where I wandered, felt the arrow deep and quill. Myself, my world, my destiny, as I'd wove a selfish net, and soon I found I'd entangled self, wrapped in every web I'd set. I used, I took, and squandered, as my sin had took my will. Dark shadows seemed to never cease, rocky ground I'd left to till. At times I'd see a distant light, through the darkness it would shine. My boat, no oars, no land in sight, as a leaf fell from the vine. One night that light, it drew me in, a strong tug within my soul. Battered, scarred, and filled with sin, a wind pushed me through the shoal. The stronger as the light grew, What was once a distant dive, as I pulled ashore, I never knew was a refuge that I sought. Once there I saw men gathered round, hurt at this place, I heard it set free. I saw men gathered round, and I heard them talking of God's love. Of darkness gone, and peace they found, because Christ died and rose above. They said, brother, come and join us, and throw away those old. Bask in the light, the truth, his word, love and peace forevermore. It was then the devil laughed and spoke, these men, they lost their mind. Let's go, my friend, it's all a joke, and of this world, we too will die. I'll walk with you, so stick by me, I'll always be your friend. Let's move along, got much to see on the road that has no end. I tossed him out, the oar and key, and I said, no thanks, you go alone. Then I got upon my knees, I cried to Jesus at his throne. As I knelt, eyes on the cross, I heard, I love you, son, this much. And as for words, I was at a loss. My heart felt God's soft, sweet touch. From that moment I have known, felt that darkness leave my heart. Free from all the seeds I'd sown, God's grace, a brand new start for all of us. A brand new life on different roads, our Lord Jesus paid for me. For all of us, he bore the load on that rugged cross at Calvary. Praise God, Jesus, for your light that made the blind to see, who took our wrongs and made them right. Your truth has set me free. Kingdom of God inside of me, of this truth he freely sends. Love, joy, and peace, eternity, streets of gold that never ends. Once I walked with guilt and shame, now on eagle's wings I soar. I write these words in Jesus' name, my Lord and Savior forevermore. Amen. Amen. And I'd like to read one more, and this is just one page though, see all the way. We had a bunch of old cross ties back there, you know, we burned wood and all. And we had a bunch of cross ties, and we were throwing them away and getting rid of them and all. And Mark asked me to build a cross out of them. So I built an old cross, and we put it out there. And I got to thinking on it one night, and just like that poem there, you know, that's not me, you know. I'm the man I came before here. You know, was pretty, he's dead. But I wrote this about the cross, and I wrote this for every brother here. And I'm gonna have a brother of mine make a copy of this, and if Mark will let me, I'm gonna put this in the dining room for all the future men to come here to read, you know, for hope. But it says, it's called the old rugged cross that set free. It says, this old rugged cross made from pieces, battered, scarred, and left to rot, tossed aside, left forgotten, as us men in emptiness filled our pot. But our God, he looked down upon it, saw a purpose, yes, he had a plan, for to send us and set free a strong message, and his truth to show every man. Our Lord took these old tattered pieces and he molded a strong rugged cross. Was his grace and love we didn't deserve as a symbol, us men to the lost. For the hopeless, downtrodden, and weary of guilt of the past things we've sowed, yes, his love, his mercy set us all free. On that cross, our Lord bore our load. So when you're down, set your eyes on that old cross. From a heap, he will build us up too. His peace and his love is unending. Will show us a life we never knew. That old cross made from pieces, like us, had no hope of its sight. But now it stands tall as a symbol, set free God, the truth and the light. And then I put John 8:32 at the bottom, and you will know the truth, which is God's word and Jesus. That's the truth. And the truth will set you free.